our dice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 33 in our series, Create a RubyGem Nerd Dice. And in this video, we're hopefully going to finish up the benchmarking suite that we have done in our last two videos. So in our previous video, we got to the point where we were printing the ratio into our script as output, and now we're going to actually go figure out what those ratios are rather than creating dummy ratios. And we want them to be relatively set to what they ought to be, but with a little bit of flexibility so that we don't occasionally fail our script for no reason. We're going to go the other way here initially. Benchmark can't be coerced into float. We'll reduce this so that we execute this faster. Secure random. Let's see if that is what we want here. 0.65, 0.85 sounds about right. So we would make that 7.5. Now we want to go the other way around there. Greater than one value. I'll call that 1.5. That was greater than one. so that should have baseline value. Baseline value times the ratio is greater than, that time it went over. For secure random, so we had point 60 and 0.85 the previous time we had 0.61. Let's increase that. So that seems to consistently pass there. And we'll go and do a similar, I'll go and do a similar analysis on the other ones. Again, I'll pause and do so. So I think I've got the ratios where I want them now. I've been running it consistently and it has been passing. I've reduced n down to 50,000 for right now. So the other thing I want to do is I want to go in here and add something inefficient into our total dice execute die roll method. To make sure that it causes things to fail. So something that will loop through a million and execute something on this every time we do execute die roll, and that should bog things down and cause us to fail here. So maybe I took a bit too long, but we can see the performance of this is suffering greatly. I exaggerated this too much. Let's take a zero off of that. Take another zero off of that. They want something that noticeably reduces performance, but not so much that we can't run our suite. Of course. So all of these are now much, much slower, and we should fail in our tests, or otherwise we've got the logic very wrong on our inequality statements. So we'll let this finish. And so we do get failure here. It's taking what we had before was our ratio. Our allowed ratio here is 1.6 for secure random, and it bumped things up to 239, and so it failed. Now we want to get rid of that inefficient statement. And we're back to where we want to be. One more thing I'm going to do here is the in the benchmark, we are going to have our error message have a little bit more. Line length RuboCop error there. We'll then have error message. Okay. create the error again with a little bit less efficient of a failure. Less inefficient. So, still failed. Allowed ratio is 1.6, actual ratio was 3.85. And that's giving us decent information about the error in addition to what is already printing in the console. So I think we can live with that. I think this is giving us a good starting point for our benchmark. We'll again get rid of the intentional inefficiency in our nerd dice class. So this is the only thing that's different now. We'll take a look and see how RuboCop is space around operators. Too long here. We will just see if we can still going to be too long. Yeah, line length. Just got our line that is too long. Maybe. responses. Okay, so RuboCop is okay with that. We will now add that. Squash these after we try pushing it. So we have to see how this runs on the remote, make sure our ratios aren't broken there. So we will go to our actions. So our benchmark failed, our ratio being 8/10,000ths too long. So we'll go in and make these each a little bit more generous. Liberalize the ratios. We shall see if that grants us a passing CI suite. And we did pass, so now we'll squash our commits. Commit message. We've got our commit message. Successfully rebased. I did not sign the message though, so I'll and make the date correct because it did take a little over an hour to do all this, so we'll do that. We'll force push. Open our pull request. Let the checks finish. And we had a failing check. It. One run of the same thing failed, and only one of it passed with the same code. So, made it 13.5, and it was 13.6. So we'll increase our ratio for that and redo our commit. So that was the randomized 3d6. Bump it up by one. Force push. Let the checks run again. And everything passed. Got no conflicts. Merge feature benchmark. We will go to our issue. Done. Make sure that our action did pass on master, so we're still passing and everything in our build. And thanks for sticking with me on this. This was a long and arduous session, but we're done with it.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.